our friend, our member, our connect, our spiritual comedic therapist. Put your hands together for our brother, T.Luv.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Absolutely. Pastor Command Ross, man, I want to do this. Fellas, y'all got something in your cup. If not, go ahead on and post something up and get a quick shot, man. We're going to toast. You know what I'm saying? I know it might be a non-traditional thing, you know what I'm saying? Toast a little yak to the preacher, but, you know. God said in this season, amen. You know, what he said, he touched the wine, amen. He didn't drink it, but we're going to toast up to our pastor. Listen, man, this is actually a dream come true for me. I'm from Macon, Georgia. You know what I'm saying? I wrote down 2 years ago. Yeah, that right. Bibb County, man, it's south of here. I wrote down during the pandemic, which I turned it into a plandemic, PLAN. And I took a job as a man serving tacos at Taco Bell because I couldn't find a job and I had to support my 2 daughters. You understand that? I don't know how to sell dope. I ain't that strategic. I ain't know how to do nothing else but to do what I do. Because they always just said I was overqualified for this one, underqualified for that one. But throughout that time, while serving tacos like a man, I wrote down a plan to make my jokes matter. So what you see now is a true testimony. So through the pandemic, I got a full-time job in Fairburn. And then from that point, I started my comedic journey. And I always wanted to be, especially when I heard that Pastor Jamal Bryan was here in Atlanta, I had to get myself connected. I didn't know that it was gonna be through my gift and talent, but the word of God says, if you write the vision and make it plain, the people will run to it. So this right here, what you're seeing is actually a dream come true for me. So I'm just giving God the glory, and I want to toast up to Pastor Ross, had I not been known on Instagram and find out about the men's sanctuary, you know what I'm saying? So there again, the vision will be made plain, and it's going to, you know, the laws of attraction is going to attract you to what it is that your heart desires. That's what the word of God says. So we're just going to toast up to Pastor Command Ross, man. Thank you for bringing us together. Thank you for giving me an opportunity to spread my gift, my talent on this platform, right? Here, here.
My man.
Yeah. Tap it. That's what we do. Absolutely. So, now, let's get to the meat and potato. What's going on? Y'all all right, though?
Yes, sir.
It's Monday. Yeah, so we talk about unhealthy relationships. So, you know what I'm saying? I got this thing where I say, you know, I'm half hood, half holy too. You don't know if you're going to get Pastor Troy or Pastor Hezekiah Walk. It's just a certain prayer life that I have. You know what I'm saying? Like the prophet Tupac Shakur, you know, ain't no killer, but don't push me. You understand? So, when we talk about unhealthy relationships, I want to go, I'm going to tap in and tap out because I got 1 foot in the street and 1 foot in the church. Not meaning that I'm a double-minded man. It just means that I know what's going on in the street and I know what's going on in the church. Mm-hmm. I know they're telling lies in the church. They're not they telling lies in the street. Mm-hmm. You understand that? But when we talk about, I was digging into my bag, you know what I'm saying, the whole day, as soon as I got the post, and Pastor sent me and said, well, we're going to talk about unhealthy relationships. And I can attest to unhealthy relationships, you know what I'm saying? I have broken hearts, and I have my heart broken, you know what I'm saying? The prophet Ralph Trez, man, said, if it isn't love, why do I feel this way? You know what I'm saying? Why does she stay on my mind? You know what I'm saying? Come on now. Come on now. We got old school R&B in here, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, when we talk about unhealthy relationships, if you got your Bible, I'm going to go in and out. So Proverbs 21:9 says that, it's better for a man to stay on the rooftop. Come on, somebody with the Bible stand. The corner on the rooftop. That means I take my pillow and go up here where it's cold at.
Yes, sir.
Before I be with an argumentative or contentious wife.
That's right.
Now, I didn't write. That was the King Solomon. So he had single ministry problems like I did while he was married. You understand what I'm saying? It's better to take your pillow to go to the rooftop where it's cold and raining and everything to be with a contentious wife. Now the caveat to that is, because I tap into it a little bit, you know what I'm saying, about unhealthy relationships. The caveat to that is saying that the frustration comes when you're trying to lead a woman when you're not led by God. Mm-hmm. So if you're led by the flesh, you got that BBD spirit. Never trust a big butt and a come on somebody in church today. I like that church right here now. I'ma come back next Monday. You understand? So you led by the flesh and you trying to be contentious. Like my brother said, you know, you got the babe
Well, 6 months, and you know what I'm saying? I've been in that same kind of state because, you know, I was in chasing the BBL ministry. Anybody know about the BBL ministry? The BBL ministry. Don't nobody know about the BBL ministry. Nobody. I'm the only one that like Big Booty right here. Big Booty Judy in the crew. I'm the only one. See, she look, yeah, the BBL ministry, not the B-I-B-L-E ministry. Uh-oh. See, because they say, well, he that finds his wife, finds for what? Good thing, but see, the trouble is, I wouldn't find a wife, I would just find somebody to sleep with, and I just, oops, I had a baby. Ooh. And then I did it again. You know what I'm saying? So I got a single ministry problem, you gotta pray for them, I got a certain prayer life. So then when it taps into that, the caveat to that is saying where you know, the frustration where you try to lead a woman and you're not led by God, and it put you in an unhealthy state of mind. So for me, how many of y'all just like me, Unc them, used to tell her, just sleep with all the women you want to, you find that one you're gonna marry. Mm. How many of us like that like me? Come on, that's the truth. We in the main sense. Yeah, my aunt them told me all that. You know what I'm saying? My partner them, I couldn't wait till I go to college. I busted wide open. You understand what I'm saying? You're talking about raw dog. I done raw dog. You hear me? I'm talking about if it was a nickname, I would beat the weapon. You know what I'm saying? Thankfully, by the word of God, I had a praying grandmother. You understand what I'm saying? And every time I come home from college on the weekend, she just prayed that I could tell you doing something. You ain't got no business. And mama just pray for me. But, so when we talk about unhealthy relationships, even when it comes to man and woman perspective, you know what I'm saying? All have been there before. It's about how can I get better when I stand better. And Doc, you touched on a good point. The more I tell Joe, the more they think they can go down there in the child support office and get some more money out of it. But they weren't trying to get no money out of it when I was selling tacos. They weren't trying to get no beef money. They weren't trying to... No S money, I don't want none of that, right? Mm-hmm. So when we talk about gathering amongst men, they say that bad company corrupts good character.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm saying? So we got people out here in gangs. We got young folk that don't want to come to church because they don't look like church folk. And so you kick them out of the church because you tell them that they don't look like church folk, but now they're the disciples. But they didn't get that scripture because church folk was supposed to open it up with the Lord. They say, come as you are. Well, they ain't had time to shop. They ain't had time to put on the suit. They ain't had time to go to SNK or DNK to get them a shirt and a suit and a tie to look like church folk. But then somebody told them to come in and get the word. So now they looking at the bad company. So now I'm going to go to the strip club because they love me. I'm going to go to the trap because I can serve and they love me because the trap don't own enough clothes. You understand what I'm saying? So when we talk about unhealthy relationship, then this frustrated man go out here. This is a soul that goes out and then he has to encounter the police. He has to encounter a gang. He has to encounter a brother that look like him. You angry just like I'm angry. So when we bump into each other just like the rain, what gonna happen? You dig what I'm saying? So when I say my jokes, man, I try to tap into the mind, not only comedically, but to tap into the mind from a biblical standpoint. Because we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against spirits and principalities that's out here. This is not a carnal warfare. So how do you suit up against somebody that's hate you? I'm saying, God, a whole world that hate me. You know what I'm saying? The white man. Another brother, you did, my baby mama's them. You know what I'm saying? You know, why are we stressed with so much hate? But through it all, we still have a cool dapper about us. You did what I'm saying? I'm seeing old and young. We got the salt and pepper, we got the fresh fade, whatever it is. That means we can come together and unite and fight what it is that's trying to kill us. You know what I'm saying? David didn't kill Goliath for Instagram followers. He killed Goliath because it was a calling to fulfill, and he seen that his brothers were scared. We had to hold the whole ark. You know what I'm saying? So we got a Goliath in front of us, y'all. We got a Goliath that we gotta fight. We can't go in it in any other way. What did David tell him? Doc, he said, "Oh, I can't go in there. Give me my 5 stone." You know what I'm saying? So say it with me. Give me 5.
Give me 5.
If you're from the hood, you say I got 5 on. You dig what I'm saying? This is yours truly, T.Luv. I'm hoping that my jokes matter to y'all. Pastor Conveyor Strong. Listen, if y'all got your cell phone, which I know you do, you know what I'm saying? Your wife been texting, talking about when you're going to come home. Go ahead on and go to the Instagram and look me up at IAMTLUV. IAMTLUV. Old school, your MySpace. You know what I'm saying? On Facebook. Facebook, my real name is Todd Davis. Okay? That's professional. But we go through Instagram because that's what the Men's Sanctuary is on. So IAMTLUV. And shoot me a text as well to let me know that you was in the sanctuary, because I like to be in the group text. We got, I got some things coming up, and I want to connect with everybody in the room. So you can jot down my number two right after that, IAMTLUV. If you can jot down my number, and I got business cards too, 478-338-2082. 478-338-2082. And just hashtag Men's Sanctuary. You know, my jokes matter, whatever. Just let me know that you are who you are. We gonna connect. Pastor Ross, thank you again,
thank you,
Doc. Yes, sir.
Give him a hand. T.Luv, y'all.